I train as a sleep consultant? I get asked this a lot, and it's often by mums who've worked with a consultant themselves and been through the journey and the transformation when they get their little one sleeping. Well, that was how it started for me too. It's like you become obsessed with kids' sleep, and when it changes your life, you just want to shout it from the rooftops and save all the other parents out there from suffering because you know it doesn't have to be that way. That's exactly how I felt. I felt like it was just unfair and totally wrong for me to keep this to myself. And even though I knew I had a lot to learn back then, one thing that I knew for sure was that too many families were suffering the deep pains of sleep deprivation. It was damaging their lives and their children's futures, and that the vast majority of these families could be on the other side where I was, with the little one sleeping soundly through the night, feeling like a new human being, happy and vibrant, and all in just a few weeks. Others that ask me about becoming a sleep consultant are nannies and childcare workers. Even if they don't have children of their own, they've often been very close to the pains of little ones not sleeping and the impact that this has. And they can see how life-changing it would be if they could actually help and make a difference for the families they work with. They also sometimes have a vision to have a business of their own to suit life when they do perhaps go on to have their own children or want to move on from the childcare world. So in this video, I'm going to share with you the simple steps to becoming a sleep consultant and starting your own business that you can run from home and fit around the life you lead. First of all, you have to decide that having your own business is right for you. When you work for yourself and you're your own boss, you have to be committed to your work time and your vision for your business as well. This is easy when you're driven by helping others and making a difference in their lives. With that as your primary objective, the rest will come together. Sleep consulting can pay you a healthy wage, but when people go into business, any business, purely for the money, it doesn't go well because they lack interest in actually doing the work. Success takes work, but it can be smart work rather than hard work if you get it right. As it stands, sleep consulting is not a regulated profession. In other words, anyone can call themselves a sleep consultant, and worryingly, some people do without any formal training or professional experience. A mother of five may feel like she has the secret to getting little ones to sleep, but there's so much more to it than that. Taking the right training is so important, not just for your own knowledge and confidence in your ability to solve sleep problems, but also for your clients to feel confident in you too. But a sleep consultant training program is only part of it. And if you want to create and grow a successful business, you need to know all the parts of that. So choosing the right training is the next step. I remember seeing lots of consultants go through some of the training programs I did many years ago. They started a business and within 6 months, they'd given up. I couldn't believe it. I was really busy and I could see no end to the volume of families out there in need of professional guidance and support. So why were they giving up on their consulting businesses? The fact was, even though they were brilliant at it, they had no business savvy, or even if they did have some experience in running a different kind of business, they didn't know how to create a repeatable process for consistently enrolling new clients into their sleep programs. There's no point in having the wonderful ability to transform lives, but then rely upon the randomness of social media or hope that clients will find you. Or the classic mistake of thinking that if you put up a website, people will find you. It's like throwing spaghetti against the wall if you don't have a strategy that you know works every time, consistently. Some sleep consultant training courses offer some insight into business basics, but you'll spend a fortune learning more or learning the hard way if you don't learn the right things from the right experts. So my advice for anyone considering taking training in sleep consulting is to be sure you're getting all the knowledge you need, not just to become a sleep consultant, but to become a hugely successful sleep consultant and business owner. That's how you impact more lives and make a bigger difference. So let's recap. Firstly, decide that it is right for you and it's what you want. Next, enroll in the training that meets your objectives and aligns with your values. Now, to do that, you've got to be prepared to invest in yourself. Cheap things aren't usually good and good things aren't usually cheap, but investment in yourself can pay you back over and over again if it's the right one. Not only did I take multiple trainings before feeling equipped as a sleep expert, I also spent multiple five figures training with the world's best online marketers and coaches and mentors. When I created Sleep Nanny Academy, I wanted to plow all of these learnings into one academy to equip people to be the best in sleep consulting, which means being brilliant in business too. When you invest in something, you do it knowing that you're going to make it back. That's the whole point of investing, right? To get a return on the investment. So it's basically just a short-term loan to yourself. If you know it's what you want, there are only two factors that can hold you back. One is fear that the training you're investing in is not going to deliver, and the other is fear that you're not going to deliver. If you're confident in both of those, you're all set to do amazing things. So the last thing that you need to do to become a sleep consultant, once you've decided, enrolled in the right training, and invested properly in yourself, is to commit. In fact, your investment was the first step to your commitment because you have skin in the game and you're serious about this. But just like a tired family's problems aren't going to magically be solved when they invest in hiring a sleep consultant, you're not magically going to be a success just because you've invested in the best training on the planet. It's up to you. You have to show up and learn and apply what you learn and then keep learning and growing. This is always another level to go to. Only you can make it happen. You're the one in the driver's seat. Your trainers and mentors can show you how, but it's you who has to do it. And there's only one you, so no one else can do your thing as you. That's amazing, isn't it? Just by being you, there can be no competition. You're the only one. Now, I've shared with you how to become a sleep consultant, but I want to share one more thing with you. Once you've got this far and you're a sleep consultant, be brilliant. Be so great at what you do that people rave about you. Serve your audience, make your impact, and you'll go very far. This world is your oyster. Are you thinking of becoming a sleep consultant? If so, tell us in the comments below. What do you do now, and what makes you want to be a childhood sleep consultant? We'd love to hear your stories. Are you worried about whether or not you could do it? I'll bet you could because you're still here, so this is obviously important to you. In fact, you can take our free mini training course to get a taster right now. There's a link below somewhere, so check it out. And until next time, be healthy, be happy, and be everything you were born to be. Thanks so much for watching. If you've liked anything about this episode, then please leave a comment below and hit subscribe for more episodes like this. If any of your friends would benefit from seeing this video, then please do share it with them using hashtag TheSleepNanny. And we look forward to seeing you again real soon.